Hello, everyone. I am Shih-Shinh Huang from National Kaohsiung University of Science and Technology, Taiwan. Today, we want to talk about an algorithm for connected component labeling. This algorithm is for binary image and process the image only in two passes. This algorithm was proposed in Journal of SEM 1966. The outline of this lecture includes introduction about what is connected component labeling and the definitions of connectivity and connected component. Two-pass labeling about the overview of connected component labeling algorithm and the operations performed in pass 1 and pass 2 respectively. CCL is a fundamental operation in many image analysis applications. The objective of CCL is to group the connected points into a region and transfer the unit to be processed from point to region. For example, in application of license plate recognition, the input image is firstly binarized by thresholding. The white points denote the object points. Black points are background ones. Then, the connected component labeling is applied to identify all regions with different colors, followed by the process to recognize each character. Accordingly, the input to CCL is a binary image, where points with zero gray value denote background points, and those with 255 denote object points. The output of CCL is a label image. The label is a non-negative integer denoting region identifier. In general, 0 is used to stand for background region. Positive integers are for object regions, and each of which is composed of connected points. In other words, all connected points are with the same label. For this example, the output of CCL is a label map consisting of two regions with label identifiers 1 and 2 respectively. Next, we define the connectivity of two points. That is, why PI and PJ are connected, but PI and PK are not connected. Before to define the connectivity between two points, we firstly introduce the idea of adjacency. Two points PI and PJ are coded adjacency of each other if their point squares share a common path. If we define the shared path is H, the adjacent points of a specific point are left, right, top, and bottom points. And this results in four connectivity. If the shared path is vertex, the adjacent points are the 8 points around a specific point, and this results in 8 connectivity. For two points P and Q, they are coded connected if there exists a path from P to Q, where points P0, P1 to Pn are all object points, and all pairwise points PI and PJ at the two sides of a right arrow are adjacent. In this example, other points P and Q are connected. For full connectivity, no path exists from the point P to Q. The points P and Q are not connected. But for A connectivity, there exists a path from P to Q, and they are connected. After introducing the concepts of adjacency and the connectivity. We next give the definition of connected component. A connected component is defined as a maxima set S of object points that are connected of each other and satisfy the following two rules. The first rule is that if P and Q are connected and P belongs to the set S, this implies Q is also in the set S. In other words, all points that are connected have to belong to the same connected component and are assigned to the same label. In this example, all points linked by the red line belong to the same connected component. The second rule is that P and Q are in S, implies P and Q are connected. In other words, points that are not connected are labeled as different connected components. In this example, since the sets of the points on the left-hand side and the right-hand side are not connected, they are labeled as two different connected components. Next, we introduce a two-pass algorithm for labeling connected components. As the name implies, this algorithm scans the image for two times. At each pass, it goes from left to right and top to bottom, and only deal with the object points but skip the background ones. For the first pass, it assigns temporal labels to all object points and records the equivalence relations between labels. In this example, we record three equivalence relations: 2 to 3, 1 to 4, and 2 to 5. In the second pass, the equivalence relations are resolved to obtain the equivalence classes. In this example, after resolving, we have two equivalence classes. After that, the smallest label in each equivalence class is used for replacing the temporal labels. Here, we take the label 2 to replace labels 3 and 5, and the label 1 is used to replace 4. Here shows the results after label replacing. Here shows the pseudocode of the two-pass algorithm. At each pass, it scans from left to right and top to bottom and skip the background points. In the first pass, it assigns temporal labels and then records the equivalence relations between labels. In the second pass, it firstly resolves the equivalence relations to obtain the equivalence classes. After that, the smallest value is used to replace the temporal labels. Next, we detail each step in the two-pass algorithm for connected component labeling. For assigning temporal label, the first step is to collect the labels assigned to adjacent points. By using for connectivity, there are four adjacent points for the currently visited point P, but only its left and top points are already visited. Accordingly, we collect the labels only from these two points. Similarly, for a connectivity, these four adjacent points are considered for label collection. The second step is to assign a temporal label to point P by propagating the labels from adjacent points N of P. If N of P is empty, we create a new label to P. Otherwise, point P is assigned to us the minimal label in N of P. For simplification, we use the four connectivity in the later discussion. Here details the steps of assigning temporal labels in our example. By scanning image from left to right and top to bottom, the adjacent labels of the first visit object point is empty. We assign it a new label 1. Then, this label is propagated to his right point. For this point without adjacent labels, again, we assign it a new label 2. Similarly, this point is assigned with new label 3. For this point with adjacent labels equal to 2 and 3, the label 2, the minimal one, is assigned to this point. Finally, the temporal labels assigned to the object points is shown in this image. At the same time for assigning temporal label, we also record equivalence relations when there are more than one different labels in N of P. Since current point P connects all different labels in N of P, we add the equivalence relation Li to Lj, where Li and Lj are different labels in N of P. In this example, these three points have the two different adjacent labels respectively. Accordingly, three equivalence relations 2 to 3, 1 to 4, and 2 to 5 are recorded. During second pass, we resolve the label equivalence before scanning the image. The first step is to create single integer item sets and then process every equivalence pair Li to Lj to form equivalence classes. Since there are 5 labels from 1 to 5 in the label image, we firstly create 5 sets and each of which consists of 1 label. For the equivalence relation 2 equivalent to 3, we unify the sets that consists of 2 and 3. Similarly, we process the second and the third equivalence relations and finally result in 2 equivalence classes. After that, we start to scan the image and replace the label at every point P by the minima of the set containing the label of point P. For this example, the minimums of the obtained 2 equivalence classes are 1 and 2 respectively. Therefore, during the second pass, the label 4 is replaced by 1, and the labels 3 and 5 are replaced by 2. Here shows the result of connected component labeling after replacing temporal labels. In summary, the temporary label assignment of the first pass collects labels in adjacent points. If N is empty, we assign a new label to the point P. Otherwise, assign the minimal of N to P. If the number of labels in N is more than 1, we take the minimal of N and add the equivalence relations Li to Lj for all elements in the set N. for resolving label equivalence of the second pass. It creates single integer item sets. Then, for each equivalence pair Li to Lj, it unifies two sets that contains Li and Lj respectively to obtain equivalence classes. Finally, we replace the label by the minima of the equivalence class containing that label. In this lecture, we introduce a two-pass algorithm for connected component labeling. Thanks for your listening and have a nice day.